Okay, and it's SK's turn to ban.
They still have 1 minute, but there is a there it is, with Tassadar being banned now.
Okay, I
Pretty
like that.
standard.
Yeah. That works. I mean, taking Tacita out first. I think Empire might ban Uther here.
Yeah, might be a possibility, but if you ban Uther now, SK might even go for a support as first pick as well, and then Empire has like only bad supports left to go for.
And we have Tychus banned. Okay, first pick for SK. And, well, thinking back, what was usually their first pick? I think it was either Tassadar
Uther.
or Uther, yeah. There he is. So, I mean, I would have liked the Uther ban for Empire.
Yeah, they still would have had the chance of just going like Tyrande, Brightwing or Rhaegar, depending on what SK chooses.
Okay, they have first their first two picks now, and the last time, as we said before, they had some really weird choices against playing with Pain. Three specialists. I hope they're not going for that again. First pick, okay,
Oh my
Asmodan and
goodness.
Zagara, two specialists again. So maybe they have something planned. Mind you, they're playing against the second ranked team right now, so. This is going to be a rough time no matter what, even if they have like a regular composition and they're still going for two specialists. So, okay, I'm kind of worried about Team Empire here.
By the way, the map is Haunted Mines, so if you have a lot of pushing power on this map, you have a good chance of winning actually, because normally there's not that much of a late game, and in the late game they specialists get really squishy.
Yeah, and I don't know. I mean, with Zagara, you do have some map control, of course, through the creep. And well, if she's playing really weird and you take the Tuddling, that could work for some decent surprises as well. But other than that, Asmodan doesn't really give you any mobility, so we still need some ability out of Empire if they want to play this right. And Arthas alongside Illidan here.
Yeah, pretty solid as well. Illidan may be a little bit of a surprise, but since they went Uther, there's absolutely no problem for them to keep Illidan alive.
Yeah. And especially with these slow specialists, I think he can pick them off really easily.
Yeah.
But with Asmodan, you can stay back a little. Stay a little bit back, stay safer. And with Zagara, you have the vision through the creep tumors. So if they play it out cautiously, I think they can survive. But they need to get ahead early on. Otherwise, they're gonna have a rough time later in the game.
Yeah, I think they really should focus on getting a fort very soon, so they get ahead a little bit on experience and then really try to snowball, play it out perfectly, and don't get behind. Just, yeah, be a little bit more defensive than normally.
Next pick, Brightwing. Okay, as you said, I mean, just a good support pick here if Uther is already taken. And I mean, he definitely has to go for the healing wave, right?
Yeah, sure.
And as yeah, a new Anub'arak for stun for initiate. I like it. Now they just need someone that has some decent tanking ability.
Yeah, but with these two heroes, they really got in some mobility. So I think they might be all right if they, yeah, just roam a little bit and have Zagara and Asmodan on one lane each. And Brightwing, for example, is really good in roaming because with the stun.
Nidoskali is asking in chat if Asmodan is viable. What's your opinion here? I think maybe he has a niche, but I feel like with this composition, it's gonna be really tough to make it work. in regular games, if you like have a well, four regular hero composition and then take Asmodan, I think he can be a viable asset, but with this composition, I'm not too sure.
Yeah, to be honest, Asmodan is really good in the early game because he has so much pushing potential. But when it gets to the mid and late game, when the team fights are really what it is about, he's kind of weak.
Okay. And we have the Witch Doctor for SK. That's kind of surprising.
Yeah, but they needed some damage, and with Nazebo you have a huge amount of damage to be dealt. So, solid pick in my opinion.
Okay. How do you think he synergizes with the remainder of the team?
He synergizes with Arthas, just because Arthas can root the enemies down, and Nazebo is gonna pop up his zombies and surround the enemies. So that's kind of a good way to go for him.
And then Tyrion combination can also pop in there if he wants to. Tyrion's last pick here for SK. So I think that's a pretty good lineup. Maybe, well, I mean Arthas has the Cold Strike, so I guess that's a good initiation, and also Tyrion, of course. That works really well. And then you have the Zeebo, of course, with the zombie wall to stop everyone and CC them in. Okay, last pick for Empire. Wow, Abathur? I don't know. Are they trolling here or what's going on?
They are running the three specialist combo once more. I'm not too comfortable with this, but maybe
No,
they have a
not at
special
all.
tactic in mind.
I don't know. Can you think of something? Maybe with the with the Abathur heroic, that makes it work really well or something. To be honest, I have no idea.
I thought about maybe they go for backdooring with Zagara, Nidus Swarm, Brightwing teleport, and Anub rushing in with his Q, I think, and then casting the ultimate on Abathur, but then Asmodan has nothing to do. It might be a combo they go for, but I don't think it's too solid.
All right, looks like almost everyone is ready.
Yeah, we have five.
And we can probably get started with the game soon. I don't know, but I mean, I feel like they have no way to actually get into team fights with this composition.
Yeah, well, they have the initiation from Anubarak. So, at least a little bit,
Yeah,
and
but who's gonna tank? A noob?
he has to. He has no choice.
Okay, I mean they have to make it work. We'll see if it actually works out in the end. We're ready. Players are ready, so we can get started here on Haunted Mines, mind you. Okay, looks like everyone's ready.
Oh, 9 from 10
No,
players.
not quite. Not quite. Of course, someone's always missing. Now we're good. We're good to go. Illidan, really? Yeah, Fergrim. Illidan was their pick, but I mean, they do have an easy way to go for this. Okay, Haunted Mines. Let's go. One thing I'm just well thinking about is the special game that we had between. Oh, I can't quite remember. I think it was Symbiote Gaming versus. Oh, jeez. Can't remember their opponent, but they had like a really nice idea with backdooring into the opposing base early on, and then using ETC to catch the damage of the first fort, taking the first fort out, and then just going all out on the Nexus. And they used the Garra and ETC, of course, for that. So I don't know if this is possible with this composition. I highly doubt it, because I doubt that they have the power to actually snipe the Nexus. But I mean, that's something to keep in mind, just these really weird tactics that are still possible if you take a lot of specialists.
Yeah, but you really rely on your tactic very much. So the opposing team, if they get what you want to do fast enough, they normally win. But let's see.
All right, on left side, in blue, here on Haunted Minds, we have SK Gaming, and they have Arthas, played by BKB, and we have Illidan, played by Zarmani. Then Tyrael, played by Rahl, Linked is playing Uther, and BZ is playing Nazebo. On the right side, as red, we have Team Empire with Nuparak, Zagara, Asmodan, Brightwing, and Abathur. And they're all going down the bot lane. Okay, let's see. Looks like SK also wants to prepare something here.
Oh, they're already pushing. Wow. Really aggressive.
I mean, that's their strength here, pushing power. Ooh, nice stun there, getting three heroes. And Zagara already taking a lot of damage. Noodles is taken out really quickly here. Oh, and Nuburak tries to get away. He's being supported by
Abathur, Brightwing?
Yeah, Abathur. Everybody, but it didn't work out in the end. And now it's just Brightwing and Asmodan taking down the bottom lane. And they're having a really rough time here against five heroes by SK.
Yeah, Zagara even took Demolitionist, so they're really going for push.
Yeah, massive pushing power. And Abathur is just supporting a noob here. Actually, wise choice. Of course, if he's playing the warrior, then he needs to have that additional power by Abathur. Well, we see another nice stun here. They're pretty much lined up, so he could make it work.
Yeah, they have so much pushing now, but on the other hand, they don't have anybody on the top lane, so Illidan was just able to get experience.
Yeah, they're losing a lot of XP, and you can already see that. Almost a level ahead already for SK, and there comes a nice stun, taking out Zagara. And, might be seeing another stun here. The noob is falling as well. Wow, Abathur can't really heal him up, or actually support him enough. Even Asmodan being blocked here, and final shot on him as well. Wow, SK is just rolling over over Empire.
It looks so easy for them just to win those fights.
Yeah, almost two levels ahead now, and
nobody's
open. I think they're blocking this bottom entrance pretty well here, but let's see how long they can hold out. Levin is already getting ready here, and he's the first one down in the mines. Probably just soloing the mines, since he knows, okay, they can't really go alone. And Abathur is taking the top lane.
Yeah, so they're pushing both lanes now. Oh, really nice engage here, and...
Noodles is gonna fall, amazing zombie wall there. On the bottom side, and oh, Brightwing, nice body block here by Tyrael, really well done. And now it's just Nuburak and Asmodan taking the bottom lane all by himself, and Illidan is just clearing house in the mines.
Yeah, he's really good at clearing. Doesn't have any mana, he can just cast his spells all the time.
Zombie wall misses here, but Asmodan is taking a lot of damage already. Oh, and there comes the stun, trying to focus him out, but a Nuburak falls first, and now Asmodan goes down, and another nice body block with Tyrael just rushing in there, and Brightwing is taken out. Zagara also blocked here by the zombie wall, but he will get away.
And BZ, he's diving too deep, he's gonna fall. Looks like he had a spike.
At the same time, Illidan is just clearing everything up in the mines, already getting 60 skulls down there. Yeah, he's having a really, really easy time.
And Noodles pushing once more, but Rahl, has to go back there.
Nice job here by Anu. Diving really deep, and looks like they can get the bottom towers to fall. Just a couple more shots here on the top tower, and it's out of ammo.
Yeah, meanwhile, we have Arthas and Illidan going for the boss, and they're going to get all of the skulls, so 100 golem going to be up soon for SK now.
Yeah, we have a really nice stun here for Anu, And they're clear, kind of clearing the level gap now. Almost up to 6. So maybe if they can hold out for a little bit longer, but now they have to fight the Gaun. And I think that's where their real troubles start.
Yeah, they will have to switch. Yeah, sorry. They will have to switch all to the top lane now. But I already have the easy camp. You already mentioned. So they won't have a too hard time defending here. They could have even gone for the hard camp now. But maybe they thought it was too risky.
Yeah, they grabbed easy first. Looks like Uther is in position to deal with the easy camp in the top lane. Arthas and Nazebo defending bottom, but already some damage done on the fort.
Yeah, really surprising. They can't push.
Nice stun there on Arthas, but he gets away, dives a little bit deeper into his own fort. It looks like they can put on some real pressure down here.
Yeah, the fort is already out of ammunition.
Wow. SK now has support of their easy camp. Oh, nice deep and save here by Asphil, but he's so low, he needs to get away.
Oh, the shield! So close, but now he's going.
Oh, and Tyrael comes in from the top and takes him out. Really nice engage here by him. Looks like they're in trouble now again. Empire, will they get away? Zagara is already trapped, also taken out. He can't help it. And SK taken out. Almost the entire team here. Oh, nice save. Nine down in the mines, but Asmodan making the mistake to get back up.
He
was trying to
game.
Trick them.
Yeah. But it normally doesn't work.
Every once in a while you see it work. And now Broadwing is the only one trying to hold his own here on the bottom lane. But he has to fight the easy camp as well. Looks like hard camp will be taken by SK in any second here. And we have the Golem almost taken out the top fort. Repairs in the works here. So it looks like Abathur can maybe save this for a little while longer. Asmodan is trying to stop this well.
SK has level 10 now, so they can easily engage now at the bottom lane and defend the fort.
Yeah,
Zagara
needs to watch out. They have almost no map vision. I mean, they're playing completely blind here. They definitely want to take out that fort, but they're in so much trouble. If SK would turn around now, they'd be so dead.
Yeah, really nice stun there by Uther on Asmodan.
There's the exchange on the fort. SK grabbing top, while Empire's grabbing bottom. And now they're making a turnaround, probably to take out this bottom fort. Maybe catch one of these heroes off guard. Looks like it might be a new move, but there's a nice stun.
Yeah, really nice.
And the enchant on Arthas.
Really nice pattern here from Zagara invading the team. And being able to go back home.
Yeah, but they're losing a lot of XP on the top lane, and Brightwing was gonna go up there, but he just turned around. Looks like they really need him down here. I mean, Brightwing's not the ideal hero to solo the lane, especially not with this composition. They definitely need that healing down here, and they should probably send Abathur up top again.
Yeah, they really need some experience now. They're 2 levels behind already, and now the next fight is going to be starting. Nice engage here on Zagara, but she's going to get away.
Amazing enchant there, just in time to save all of these heroes. So Brightwing desperately needed down here, and he was there to make it work. Maybe we have a second to check out the talents. We have Army of the Dead on Arthas. Maybe not. Metamorphosis on Illidan, Judgment on Tyrael, Uther has Divine Storm of course, and Ravenous Spirit on Zebo, so no surprises there. And there's the engage. Oh, Asmodan is trapped, but nice stun on right in the middle down there saves them. Nuke doing a really good job here, and Body Block on Arthas. But can they dish out enough damage to take him out? Doesn't look like it. Asmodan falls. Nuke might fall.
Just everybody's gonna fall.
Yeah, everyone's
so much
gonna
damage
fall.
By
Abathur is the only one left alive here, and I doubt that he can actually save this bottom fort. But SK is going for the mines. Just taking out the mines. No real challenge there. And I think they might not have enough time to even just grab an easy camp to support their own golem.
They're just gonna clear the whole mines and get 100 skull golem again, and after that, they maybe go for the easy, just going to push very hard now.
Oh, Empire tries to push a little bit further here. Probably going to take out the top fort, but I doubt they have the time. SK is almost done with the boss down here. And they have so many skulls again. And check out where the golem is spawned for them. I mean, he can just march on, and will probably take out this top fort in the main base of Team Empire. But they will snipe the top fort, so that's going to give a nice little experience boost. Let's check out their level 10 talents. We have Devouring Maw for Zagara, Demonic Invasion for Asmodan, Ultimate Evolution, of course, for Abathur, Locust Swarm and Anub, and Emerald Wind on Bright. Wow! Emerald Wind on Brightwing, okay.
Yeah, I think it's an okay choice for this team composition because they really want the other team not to be right in front of their face. Just keeping a nice distance because most of them are ranged heroes. So
Okay,
it's.
Ufo scouts out that they're going for the easy camp here, but he wasn't quite there in time to stop it.
Meanwhile, we have Illidan defending the bottom. Golem without any troubles.
Well,
So.
you can just take him down, solo him out, no real worries there. And I don't know, wow, counter pushing by Empire, that's kind of weird. I mean, I think SK might have enough to just win the game right here now. I doubt that counter pushing will be the right choice. Oh, they might get a hood on Illidan here.
Yeah,
Nope,
Illidan
not
can't
quite.
really defend much here.
Yeah, it's gonna follow. It's just gonna be a base race, I guess. But SK is turning around with three heroes at least, and have a nice engagement. Wow, Ultimate Storm really working well for him, and looks like they can take out Zagara. Nope, not quite. Devouring Maw comes in, but Zagara is taken out in the end, and Asmodan will fall next. Anub, the only one left alive here. Brightwing falls, and Anub, he tries to escape, but I doubt he'll get away. Nope, nice finisher by Illidan. Just taking him out, and that's almost a complete team wipe. I mean, Abathur the only one left alive here, and he's gonna take on the boss.
Yeah, with this 100 Skull Golem, it's so easy to push, even if you are not there. I think they did a really good call because they are so much better in fights, it doesn't really matter. So they don't go for the base race. Play it safe, they are already 3 levels ahead, so they won't have any problems in the future.
Yeah, I mean, what can Empire really do now? I mean, I feel like they have this really defensive layout with the repair on forts and everything, but it always comes a little bit late, and their counter pushing potential, while it is actually pretty high, of course, with these all of these heroes being specialists, but you see that every single team fight, every time they over well, they'll just over push, I guess, and they just die. So Asmodan just sacrificing himself here, but he's not gonna save the fort.
Yeah, perfect example for what you just said.
Yeah,
They're
just
way too
overextending too
aggressive.
much. I mean, you have to play it really defensive, and I don't think Heroes is the game for that. Maybe they find a strategy that can make it work, but not with the way they play it right here in this game. Nice stun there. Grabbing Arthas and Tyrael.
Yeah, even with no camps pushing now, SK has not that much of problems going in there. Really nice maw,
Oh,
but
wow, that was an amazing maw. Getting three heroes, jeez. Really good job. That's what they need for the team fights. I mean, if the maw would hit every single time like that, I think they could actually stop this. Oh.
But it's still very hard. And yeah,
Yeah. Good
Abathur's
stun on
guard.
Zagara. She does get away for now, though. And another maw here.
Yeah, hitting nothing.
But Anub falls, and with them, you know, with him down, they don't have enough. Yeah, they don't have enough soaking potential. So the bottom fort is gonna fall as well. But SK might be on retreat mode for now.
They're gonna get the fort, go back. Well,
yeah,
Tyrael
just wants to go for the fort. And will he get away? Will he get away?
very
Oh, it's gonna
clutch.
be close. Yeah. That was pretty
Ooh.
close.
Asmodan hit him, but it wasn't enough with his Q. But it was close though. So mines are going to open very soon now. SK going back to heal. Pretty good decision. So if
Yeah.
they go mines now, they won't have any problems
They
winning a team fight.
won't risk anything here. I think they could even just take the mines and disregard everything else. Just take the mines and let the boss solo the Nexus.
Yeah.
Oh, nice stun here on Asmodan. And yeah, being body blocked, he has no chance to escape, even with Abathur helping him out there.
Yeah,
and
really.
Another stun here on Brightwing. Oh, he gets pushed away and focused out as well. Wow, really no chance in hell that they can really turn this around.
SK might even be able to just end the game right there.
Yeah, they're not even going for the Skulls, you're right.
Yeah, it's so easy now, they're almost 4 levels ahead and Nul's just falling like a fly, basically. Good maw, but just focus on the core and they'll be able to win.
Nice trap here on the Nuke, just one more time. Oh, good deep dive, getting away for now. But yeah, being the only one, you can't really stop him. There's a heal again on the Nexus, but it's taking so much damage. And there's a GG. 1-0 for SK. And I don't know, I gotta say, I mean, this has been kind of a stomp.
Yeah, they have gone in this match as being a favorite, and they turn out to be the better team in this game. By the way, we even had double Mule on Empire, so they went like really defensive.
Mm-hmm.
That's kind of surprising as well. Normally you don't go a double Mule, but in this comp it worked kind of.
Alright, do you think they're gonna try that same composition again?
I'm worried that they will be.
Yeah, I mean, we saw it last time. I didn't see the games on Saturday. Did you check those out? Did they also play this really high specialist composition?
I'm not sure if I remember correctly, but I think they did go for some specialists once more, yeah.
I feel like they're always trying to play this if they feel like they have no chance with a regular lineup. Not too sure about it, but I don't know. Jan told me that he's the captain of Mousesports. He told me that they always pick these really weird heroes.
Yeah.
So, I mean, it had to work at least twice. I mean, they already have 2 wins, so it had to work at least twice. Or they just played some regular heroes because their specialists already got picked. I don't know. We'll find out. Let's see if we can get the next draft already going here. Looks like they're not quite ready yet. Yeah, but let's have a look at... actually, I didn't quite capture that. I thought we might have a replay of one of the team fights, but I didn't quite catch it. Well, I mean, we saw that they have some really good pushing power with this composition. But as soon as they overextend even a little bit, as soon as they, well, I don't know, for example, go behind the walls or are a little bit constricted or just surprised by, for example, Tyrael blinking in there, it's always just this, well, surprise attack, and they can't get away in time because, well, they're not really mobile enough, and they don't have anyone to tank up the damage. So once they overextend, that's just it, and it's always going to be a complete team wipe.
Yeah, that's really the biggest problem of the combo. But, well, they wanted to go for it, and that's what happens sometimes. Or in most of the times, if you're playing against a very good team.
Alright, we have someone asking in chat, Strupius is asking in chat, how is it possible to participate in the league? I think this season, of course, is locked, and then next season you can go check out nexuschamp.com, and I think they probably, I don't know if it's invite-based, but you can probably ask them. If your team has a good enough MMR, you can probably at least try to play on the normal regular season, or, I don't know, somehow apply. Gotta ask Nexus Champ, our main mod, for that.
I think they didn't announce anything yet, but they might even go for qualify if there are way too many teams wanting to participate.
I think the team number is gonna explode soon anyways. With BlizzCon incoming, I think this weekend. Yeah, a lot of exposure for heroes, and we'll probably see some kind of, I don't know, like a team explosion in all of these weekly cups and whatnot.
Yeah, in the draft, Empire is already ready. We are only waiting for SK now. And there is already a lobby. So maybe they're gonna start soon. Looks like the map is going to be Garden of Terror.
Oh wow. With Garden of Terror, this well, I don't see really see these specialist compositions working either way. Maybe I don't know. No. No, I don't see it happening. I don't see it happening at all. Okay, I just hope that they choose a decent hero composition this time around. Okay, still waiting on the remaining players.
Empire isn't here yet, but
Okay, let's talk about the upcoming matches, since we do have some downtime right now. After this, we have Playing with Pain versus Prism. And Team Prism, of course, is currently last, tied with Vega Squadron. They only have one win and four losses. So last place tied with Vega Squadron. And Playing with Pain, third position, two wins, two losses, and only four games played. So that's pretty good, tied with Mouse Sports, of course. So I don't know, looks like Team Playing with Pain definitely has the upper hand in that matchup. And then following that, we should be seeing, well, we would regularly be seeing i2heart versus Heroes War. Oh no, wait, never mind. That might be our replacement match.
i2heart versus Vega Squadron.
Yep, that would be the regular match, but Vega Squadron ran into some troubles. I'm not gonna go into detail here. I don't know, it's quite hilarious actually, but well, not for them. And the final match of the day is gonna be Mouse Sports versus My Insanity, and I think that's the big one for tonight. Mouse Sports tied with Playing with Pain for third place, and My Insanity the pack leader with five wins, zero losses, so 15 points. And we're going into the draft, so let's check it out. First ban this time for Empire. And I'm hoping to see an Uther ban.
Yeah, they banned Tychus last time.
Yeah, I feel like, I mean, Tychus is a really solid choice, of course, but Uther is more important, I feel, for these team fights later on with Divine Storm. And their ban is Arthas.
Yeah, quite interesting. Normally you don't see Arthas banned.
Yeah. Going for these warrior bans, I don't know. I'm not too sure what they're thinking here.
They're still like Anubarak, Tyrael, and Chen as very viable warriors left now.
Okay. Tychus ban for SK. Okay, double warrior ban. Okay, whatever they feel like doing here. I mean, one thing. I feel like the reasoning for Empire here on the ban for Arthas is that it's a regular SK pick, so maybe just throw him out of the game with picking off banning Arthas.
Yeah, it might be. Okay, so they're just wanting to pick off the warriors from SK, but yeah, going for Stitches quite standard. Doesn't look like they will be going for a specialist combo this time, because if
Let's
you hook
hope not.
someone to yourself and the specialist is right besides you, not that of a good idea.
Yeah, and with the specialist composition, since they do have the Garden Terror on this map, I feel like it's not quite as strong. And Tacita Uther, first picks here for SK. Already getting started with the standard composition.
Yeah,
No real surprises.
but it's so strong. Tacita, Uther, you most of the times even have Tacita band or Uther band, and if they get both of them, it's just they have so much stun, so much AoE damage. Really, really solid there. Just like we know it from SK.
Okay, Empire. What are you guys going for?
Maybe they don't have to pick a support now, so they will just go for some kind of assassin. Melee range doesn't really matter. They could go for Zeratul. Stitches is almost every time a good combo to go for. But let's see. Since they don't have Arthas, normally you don't go Kerrigan, but could still
Zagara
be.
again. Okay.
Well,
Well, if it's only gonna be Zagara, I'm still fine with it. If they pick another specialist, that's where the troubles start.
yeah. Then they would just go for mass push combo, and that really didn't work out, and I don't think it will work out. Depending, yeah. I just hope that they go for some standard stuff, so we
Yeah.
don't see a complete stomp again.
Maybe Valor and later on picking Rhaegar.
Might be, yeah.
As just something to trigger Bloodlust. But then I don't know.
Well,
Well, if Zagara stays back and you go really well, really hardcore warrior style on Stitches, maybe it works out.
yeah, but the problem normally is if you go Rhaegar, you need Tacita or Tychus or at least Illidan to make Bloodlust viable.
Okay. Well, we have a noob as the second warrior, I guess. And this gives double initiate, which is actually kind of nice.
Yeah, interesting because it's two completely different ways of initiating.
Right. And then you also have Devouring Maw later on for Zagara. So I like this a lot better than their last composition already, just because they have. Well, they have actually ways to deal to deal with the opponent in team fights.
Stitches just has to pay attention to not hooking Uther. And since SK knows Stitches is going to be the hero they play against, they won't go for anything really squishy. Like Tacita is already a very good hero, because if he gets hooked, it's no problem at all
Yeah, he
with
can
his
always
E.
get away.
Phase shift is really strong there.
I mean, the only time you really run into trouble if you're hooked, well, if he devours you and drags you on behind the walls. Okay, Nova and Illidan. Okay, you were talking about not squishy. So I don't know, maybe they don't feel that Empire is confident enough with their stitches or something like that. Because Nova, really squishy. Illidan, maybe so. I don't know.
Yeah, Nova has to be really, really careful not to get hooked, but since she has her trait being invisible, or at least not completely invisible, but some kind of. It shouldn't be that of a big problem, but when the stitches is really good, she might have not that of a good time living.
Yeah, I feel like Illidan is just picked here to take care of Zagara.
Yeah.
Because he's gonna have an easy time just catching up to her and hunting her down. Okay, last picks now for Empire. First one, Raynor. Okay.
Yeah, they needed some more damage, so quite good choice since Tychus isn't available.
Okay, now who's gonna be support here?
I don't think they'll go for Rhaegar since we have Uther on SK.
So maybe Brightwing?
Yeah, might be an
Or,
option.
I don't know, Brightwing, Tyrande, not so much. Probably Brightwing. I mean, they played Brightwing last game, so probably highly likely that they pick him again.
And since we are on Garden of Terror, you need some mobility. And if Brightwing goes for Bribe, you normally get a free easy camp and can be everywhere at the same time. Basically, that's what Brightwing adds to the team.
Okay, 14 seconds left. They're really taking that. Ooh, wow, okay, Malfurion.
He synergizes really well with Stitches if you play him correctly, just placing the E down and
Yeah.
rooting the enemies right after
Just
they got.
in time to get them in the hook position. And Tyrael, for SK. So SK is going for a more standardized lineup and Empire of for a lot better lineup than last game. I wouldn't quite call it standardized because they have Stitches and a noob, and usually you go for either one of them. But I do feel like both of these lineups could work. But then again, SK is in second place right now. They're really strong, and they do have a little bit more solid of a lineup here.
I would have actually liked Empire to go for something like Kerrigan, because then they would have been able to go roaming with Anubarak and Kerrigan. That's really strong roaming. But yeah, I think they won't go roaming too much now on Garden of Terror, so more of a standard. We have to ready up in the lobby.
Yep.
Oh. We have to wait for noodles now. He's gonna go to the bathroom.
Little bathroom break for noodles. So let's talk about this composition a little bit more. Of course, you got the initiate for SK with Tyrael. Then you have both Nova and Illidan to kind of hunt down the squishy targets. And Uther later on for Divine Storm, Tassadar, just all-out support, I guess.
Yeah, they really need the support if they go for Nova and Illidan. So two supports is already better than one. And yeah, I think they'll just focus on Illidan not to get him killed early on in the fight. Because when Illidan stays alive in the first some seconds of the fight, he normally stays alive the whole time.
Well, and with Empire, you said it before, Stitches alongside Malfurion, just hook him, root him, then maybe a noob to get the reinforcements. I don't know. That might work. I mean, think about it. If you have a really tight spot where you have this initial initiation with Stitches and Malfurion, and then they come in trying to rescue their friend there, and then you have a noob stunning everyone. I don't know, it's theory crafting, of course, but I like the idea.
Yeah, it's like a little bit like if you go for Void Prism, actually, which you just described. Yeah, might be an option. And as well, we have a nice synergizing of Zagara and Malfurion, because if Malfurion roots right after the Maw, you have two or three people being rooted. And with the follow-up of Anubarak, you can stun them really
Yeah, I mean,
nicely.
just so much CC with this composition. You have the root, you have the root by Malfurion, you have the line stun by Anub, you have the Maw with Zagara. If they really time it well, this is just nuts. They could take out, like, single out individual targets. But if it doesn't work out, they don't have enough damage to really kill off their opponents. Or they might actually get killed out first with Illidan and Nova for SK. Okay, I gotta feature some of these players here. Zarmani's just said, be right back, cat on fire. And we had someone in chat saying something funny too. I can't really pronounce that name. Licky Yule or something. Team Empire was handpicked by Vladimir Putin himself. By the way, there's no draft mode in Heroes yet, so this is actually handcrafted by one of the guys supporting the Heroes Premier League. So supporting the entire tournament here in Nexus Champ, of course. But it's re working really well, and it's quite nice. So I do hope that we actually see it in the game soon. Maybe even for BlizzCon this weekend. I don't know.
That
Maybe.
would be so nice.
Yeah, that'd be pretty incredible.
I'm hoping for them to announce the beta and going for a draft mode. That would be so nice. But they have to announce something, so we can be a little bit hyped.
Okay, Noodles should be back soon. And then we'll get started. Yeah, Sticks agrees with us. SK has a little bit better setup, but it all depends who initiates best with Tuuriel and Noob and Stitches. Well, lots of initiation potential for Empire. Looks like we're ready and loading into the game. The map is going to be Garden of Terror, and Empire is facing off against SK Gaming. SK leading, of course, 1-0. Just stomping over Empire, not having a real chance in that last match, of course. With a three hero specialist setup, they never really had a chance there.
Yes. Right after this game, there should be a PvP against Prism. So I don't think we're gonna have that of a big break
Yeah.
if we have one. So really nice.
I think yeah, you're right. Well, if they can take it to a third game, then we're gonna have a little bit of a delay for Prism and PvP, but I think we're all good for now. All right, on the left side, spawned in blue, we have SK Gaming. They're currently leading 1-0 against their opponent, Team Empire. And they have Tyrael in the middle. On top, we have Illidan. And also down here, Uther and Nova. And in the bottom lane, Tassadar. On the right side, Team Empire in red, with Malfurion on top, Zegara soloing the middle. And in the bottom lane, we have Anub, Stitches, and Reyner.
Yeah, so it looks like Empire is going for very fast kill on bottom lane, but as Tassadar is already going for his Oracle, nothing is going to happen to him.
Looks like SK tries to hide here in the middle, but I think that Empire knows what's up, and Noodles is staying back. He's playing pretty safe here. I think he should be fine for now.
Yeah, already spreading his creep quite good. And Nova might be in trouble now if there comes a hook from Asphel. Oh.
Not quite getting the minion there. And Tyrael is safe for now. And I'm not getting the stun off. Oh, actually, Tyrael might be in a little bit of trouble here if a noob gets off a good stun.
Yeah, he's quite offensive.
Ooh, Zagara was picked off here in the middle. So, not playing as safely as we thought. Let's
I
check
didn't
out
even see
Malfurion and
it.
how he's doing in the top.
Just a few moments. I hope you're ready.
Yeah.
Okay, almost nighttime here. And no engage on Tyrael.
Yeah, Noodles is playing it way safer now, and I think SK is just going to go for all of the seeds early on. They won't have too big of a problem
Yeah,
since.
we already have Uther and Nova kind of roaming here. And looks like they're trying to get it set up here. Yep, and there they are. Oh, I like that. Nova waiting here, close to Uther, just to, well, support him if necessary, and then jump in if any of Team Empire's players are coming out.
Yeah, easy camp being taken here by Empire, and but doing this is a little bit bad for them because they lose some seeds, but of course now they have the pushing power in the bottom lane, being able to maybe go for the Garden Terror right now.
Yeah, but they lost a lot of seeds actually, and Tyrael? Is he in trouble? No, looks like he's fine for now. Stitches on cooldown with his hook. And I think he can probably deal with these easy mobs down here.
Okay.
And now they're going for the Garden Terror of their own. And same thing goes for SK.
Yeah. So no big gangs coming in there. So both teams should be quite fine.
Yeah, I do feel that SK got the better deal here, getting a lot more seats early on. And, well, we see that Tyrael has, well, a little bit of a rough time to deal with these mobs, but he can just heal back up and he'll be fine. He just needs to watch out. Maybe there's a gank incoming. Ooh, got lucky there. Just Rainer, a noob, was a little bit later on joining the fray, but just a little bit too late there.
Yeah, so top Terror being killed now as well, so we have the Garden of Terror growing for the blue team, for SK. They might be pushing somewhere, and yeah, they're going for the easy camp now and top to be able to probably push on multiple lanes, as you normally do it if you go for the Garden of Terror.
Asphel missing his hook here, unfortunately, otherwise Tacita is pretty much uncatchable there in the middle lane, so a really wise choice for the middle lane. And they're going for the easy camp now. And then they're probably just going to push down top. And Malfur might be in a little bit of trouble here.
Yeah, but I really like the split pushing here from SK going for maybe mid and or bot with the Garden of Terror.
Yeah, he's kind of switching between lanes and trying to catch one of these heroes maybe off guard. And Anoop gets the stun off. Looks like they can single him out here. He's a little bit undecided. Maybe they just want to, yeah, use that to have their advantage to do that split push, yeah, just way more efficiently.
He just wants to keep the heroes on bottom lane busy, and he's doing quite good. We still have the easy camp pushing, so they might even get the fort, but yeah, nice engage here by...
Ooh, Anoop comes in from the bottom, but he's quite exposed down there. And so is Asphel up top. Zeratul moves in, Illidan moves in, but he doesn't quite get on top of him. And Zagara really exposed as well. Stitch is moving out, and there's the stun on him. They can probably single him out now. Quite a little bit missing the body block there, but getting sniped off by Nova. Really well done.
Yeah, but they lost the easy camp now, won't get the fort. Only one kill. I think it's not too bad for Empire. They could have gone worse.
Yeah, definitely. But Zagara was a little bit out of position down there. I felt like she would have been a lot safer just staying close to the fort and not being down there, because that way she kind of forced Stitches to move out in that fight, and that was not really necessary.
Yeah. Now they might be pushing bottom again, but Raul being really defensive here, very nicely done.
They're missing a lot of XP right now in the middle lane. And this also gives SK the potential to take down this gate, maybe.
Yeah, but they are better off just going for the camps. Let them do the job. And Empire thinks the same way, I think. Yeah, they're gonna go for the hard or easy camp now.
Yep, clearing the easy camp, and it's going towards the middle, of course. And we should be seeing a team fight here pretty soon, because SK is almost level 10, and they definitely want to force a team fight once they're 10. There they are, going for 10. There's the stun on Mathurin. Can he get him off? Ooh, wasting him on a storm there, but getting the final blow with Nova.
Yeah, but
he's just on top of it.
Divine Storm only has a 70 seconds cooldown, so it's not that of a big deal just killing one hero with it.
Yeah, and now they have the easy camp, which also puts on a lot of pressure here in the middle lane. So that, I mean, I think you're right, that Divine Storm definitely wasn't wasted. Oops. Wow, amazing wall here! Getting Anoop and Rainer with that. Wow. Really nicely played out for SK.
Really?
And now they have all the time in the world to just take on this bottom Garden Terror, get a lot of seeds, and yeah. Team Empire is taking top, and still a lot of heroes on cooldown.
I'm really surprised by the force wall. Nobody normally goes for it. Everybody just goes for the Arcan, but it worked out so far.
Yeah, and if you look at the map layout here for Garden of Terror, you have a lot of these small choke points, and a lot of potential for the wall to do this massive damage. And since they are a little bit behind as far as team initiation goes, Mephirion getting stunned there, missing the Divine Storm. And Ufa taking a lot of damage, and now the wall saves them on the retreat. But there's the Maw, maybe getting one hero there. No, nothing really taken. Oh, the Illidan was in there.
Really nice ult by Nova there. And it looks
My Furion's being hunted down. Jeez, how could they turn this around? And it looks like Zagara might also go down. There's the body block alongside the wall, and Zagara can't be saved. She also goes down. And now I think they could probably just snipe down this fort. It's out of ammo. Illidan's going for it straight away, but Reyna and Stitches are moving in. Maybe they can get him, but Tyrael's there to save him.
Yeah. Illidan is just so mobile. Normally, you are not able to hunt him down. And already two levels now, almost three levels behind here for Empire. They don't have a single kill yet. They really should go for some kind of ganks.
Yeah, Tyrael is going for the Garden Terror. I'm kind of surprised that they actually take Tyrael in the Garden Terror.
Yeah.
Because he's good for initiation, and then, I don't know, they're kind of missing something. But then again, they're two levels ahead. Ooh, nice hook here on Tassadar. And, there's the Devour. Gets him behind the wall. But, we're not quite getting out. Really well done. Looks like the wall might save him here, though. Oh, Ral taking out the wall just in time. Really well done.
SK is just gonna take off easy camp now and continue pushing. They will have a quite easy time, as it looks like. Oh,
yeah,
missing.
This middle fort is definitely gonna fall.
And yeah. Nova is being in trouble here.
Yeah, Nova might actually fall this time. Oh, but Stitches goes down. Oh, and a nice heroic there right in the middle. And getting Reyner and possibly a noob here. Nope. First, Zagara falls and a noob might get away. Oh, there's the hunt.
Oh, and Nova was so low the whole time and she still got out alive. Really well done by BZ.
Middle fort and three heroes on top. And Furion is on the run as well. I doubt that he can get away.
Yeah, so the top fort is gonna fall. Bot fort is gonna fall. And Furion obviously is gonna
fall. What the hell is he doing? Okay, that's a really weird escape. Can he get away? Tassadar is on the hunt. Oh, and there's the wall again, and the snipe by Nova. So my Furion is gone, and he's missing in the next fight as well.
Look at the levels, it's almost four levels now. So, yeah.
I feel like Empire definitely has some catching up to do.
Yeah. SK is so dominant. Of course, they seem to be the better team right now, but Empire just doesn't have the right ideas now to counter them.
Yeah, we talked about the initiation beforehand, and I feel like they're really missing their moments here. They don't quite have the map vision to pull these massive initiates off. And, that was decent, but there's the stun again by Uther, and Getting Stitches here, caught in between everything. And again, the heroic by Nova, taking so much damage there on Stitches.
Oh, and really nice heroic here from Tyrael, and they're just finishing off everybody.
Yeah. Entire team wipe, top four is gonna fall. Yeah, they just know how to initiate these fights.
Yeah, so perfectly done here, with Illidan going behind the wall, and Tyrael obviously jumping in there. And with the force wall, they might even be able to end it right away now.
Yeah, they could probably just close off the Nexus start there, and then just go for the Nexus, just snipe it out. Yeah, they dish out a lot of damage. I think they can just do it.
Yeah. So, GG.
Noob tries to get in there, but there's the GG. 2-0 for SK, and I gotta say, no surprise, no real surprise here. Better composition for Empire this time around, but in the end, their initiates were just way weaker. They really didn't know how to how to start these team fights off, and then, I don't know, taking maybe the wrong angle in some of these initiations, and SK is just way too solid for that. They're not going to make these same mistakes.
And only one kill this time again for Empire. Kind of sad, but they didn't play that bad.
No, it was way better than the first game, but still, there's like a massive difference between these teams. Yeah, Empire definitely has a lot of catching up to do if they want to play with the big boys. But again, there is the next season, so they can train a lot harder, get used to the new lineup. They've only been playing for a couple weeks now with their new lineup, so maybe they need to get used to these players, and then in the end, just make it work.
Yeah, so now we have Plan with Pain is Pain upcoming against Team Prism. Might be a little bit more interesting, but I think PPP is the favorite in this game once more.
Yeah, do you know if they're ready yet?
The draft isn't ready yet, but I think the teams are at least ready, so everybody's online.
Trying to check out some of these early engagements. Yeah, just taking a look back. Give me a sec here. There we go. Okay, so I want to show how SK just got the upper hand in these engagements, because this was the engagement where Zagara just moved out of position and kind of force Stitch's hand, because we have Zagara and Anoop and Malfurion fighting down here, where the entire action for SK just goes towards the top, goes towards that fort, and Stitch is already taking a lot of damage here, and they just have the way better angle. They're in a concave here, and now you had Illidan engaging everything, and well, I think what their plan here was that Zagara moves in from the bottom and they just close everything down. But without a noob there to give the initial line stun off, it just doesn't work out. Because they're really missing the stun here. Once the stun comes in, they can just go for the deep dive with a noob, move in with stitches, probably take down Illidan. But in the end, they just get raffle stun. Because now stitches is out of position. We have everyone just closing in on him. Usually you wouldn't go for the warrior, but if he's that exposed, yeah, just go down on him. Try to body block him. He does get away for now, but then in the end, he gets taken out here by Tezzet, I think. And Anoop, being the only warrior up there, he really has no chance, and that's the time they should be retreating. And just really well played by SK. And if we check out the map, then Reyner wasn't even participating in their fight. Zagara stayed way back. She was low, of course, so that's actually a good idea. But maybe stay close to the fort, throw a couple of banelings down there, just to help somewhat in the fight. I mean, you play safe, but still somewhat help out your team. All right, so. What's the deal on the next game here? Playing with Pain versus Team Prism. Any updates?
Yeah, both of the team captains have the link, as far as I know. They're just choosing the map right now.
Okay. Can you tell me how the map choices work?
Yeah, it's actually, I think, first ban. Okay, so the one team bans, another team, the other team bans, and then the first team selects the first map.
Okay, and then it's probably the team that also gets the second pick that gets the first map ban.
I think so, yeah.
Okay, that works out. That works out. All right. How can you get involved in Hearts? Hexar is asking us. Well, you just play the game, try to get good, get a couple friends together, and well, if your MMR is high enough, you'll for sure play against one of these teams. And if you're there, you'll be notified. They definitely get in touch with you. It's so far, at least in Europe, the Heroes Pro scene is a very tight-knit community, And I think they're very welcoming to any new players that are up there.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, still waiting on players.
It seems like they're not sure who has to ban first. I don't know as well, but they'll sure find out now. I think PPPs has to ban first, since they are on the top of the schedule.
Yeah, and also they're on a third position. I don't know if the rankings matter yet, or if they only matter for the playoffs, who gets to ban, pick first and whatnot. Probably only for the playoffs, but I'm not too sure. Okay. Yeah, so Playing with Pain is now coming up against Team Prism, third place versus last place, eighth position here. But maybe they can surprise everyone.
Yeah, definitely possible. There's always surprises in Heroes of the Storm.
Yeah, especially with this comeback possibilities. Those are, I think, the most amazing games is when you think you've lost and then you can make a turnaround happen. Alright, if we can't get started right away with the next game, then we're gonna go on a short commercial break and we'll be right back with Playing vs. Pain vs. Team Prism in week 6 of the Heroes Premier League. Be right back. Alright guys, we're back with the Heroes Premier League week 6 in Europe. And yeah, our next match is starting, Playing with Pain versus Team Prism, and we're already in draft, so let's get started. Oh, first ban is Tyrael by Playing with Pain. And the ban for Team Prism, Tassadar. Regular bans.
Yeah.
I like
him. Standard. Tyke is pretty standard as well. They can go for a lot of combos now. Really fast picking here, I like it.
Yeah, Tychus, first pick here for Playing with Pain, and Arthas alongside a noob for Team Prism.
Yeah, so they already took two tanks,
yeah.
And since Tyrael has been banned by PPP, they have to go for like Shen or something like this.
Okay, well, since they already got Arthas and a noob, yeah. Who do you think another possibility would be here? Because I don't think that Shen is quite up there with the rest of these heroes.
Yeah, sure. I don't think so too. But I think he has still a place in being viable. Another choice would be Sonya, for example, but mm-hmm. She isn't really that kind of a tank who can absorb an incredible amount of damage. So more kind of, yeah.
She gets stronger later on though, especially with Resurgence of the Storm. She gets really strong. Well, we do have Uther and Reyner picked for Playing with Pain. So I'm really waiting on their good initiate here. Ooh, and Rega and Falstad. Or Prism.
Yeah, Rega is quite obvious, to be honest, because
yeah.
They, of course, don't want PvP to go for the Bloodlust combo, which would be really strong with Raynor and
Tychus, yeah.
Tychus, yeah.
So we're going to see Brightwing out of Playing with Pain, I guess. Maybe Malfurion, because, what? Okay. Oh, never mind. I totally forgot about Uther right
Ooh,
there.
Ooh, and I totally forgot about Stitches. Oh my god. Of course, I can go for Stitches.
Yeah, Stitches works, of course, and Zeratul to top it off. Okay. We got Aberthur as the final pick for Team Prism. That's a little bit unusual, but then again, I don't know, I'm not too sure what to make of this for Prism.
Yeah, I'm not sure as well, because he normally has to duplicate Falstad, and Falstad doesn't really go with Bloodlust, so I'm quite sure they're gonna go for Ancestral Healing on Rega,
mm-hmm.
Just trying to have as much sustain as possible, and then dishing out a lot of damage with double Falstad.
Okay. Well, maybe we'll see a double Rega and get double the double Bloodlust or double the Ancestral Healing.
I don't even think double Bloodlust works or it stacks. Oh, but.
No, I mean that would be pretty amazing if it did. Our first map is going to be Cursed Hollow.
Yeah, quite good go here from Team Prism with Falstad.
Yeah,
because we really have to jump around a lot with the tribute spawning, and you can easily grab it.
Yeah, and then again, if you have a double Falstad, that makes it so much easier.
Yeah. And Falstad is quite good as well, because there are a lot of chokes where the team fights normally happen, obviously around the tributes, and Shock and Awe gets really strong there. But on the other hand, Uther is ridiculously strong as well on this map. Of course, he's strong in general, but especially on this map, he can do a lot.
Alright, let's get started here on Cursed Hollow. should be loading in here any second.
There it is.
There it is. And our Team Blue is playing with Pain. And they have Tacita, Stitches, Reyna, Tychus, and Uther in the top lane. On the right side, we have our red team with Abathur, Arthas, Anubarak, Rhaegar, and Felstead in the bottom lane. So looks like they're kind of missing out on the top lane for now.
Yeah, maybe. Okay, Anubarak is going there. I don't think Prism will try to get an early engage because always you normally don't want to go for an early engage if you're playing against Stitches. He's just so good.
Yeah.
If he hooks someone, he basically is dead.
Yeah, he's extremely dangerous, especially early on if you don't watch out. And well, you gotta watch out with him. Oh, we have a little little vision there given out by Abathur.
Yeah, nice mind there, scouting Pain and dealing a little bit of damage already. And Hysterica has to be a little bit careful here, but I think he's staying back enough, so Tangra won't be able to get in a route here.
Yeah, good tumors or good visions by these mines for Abathur.
Yeah, it looks like Falsehead won't have any problem at all. And PvP is going for the easy camp now. Oh no, they are defensive. I think that's the right call here.
Yeah, at least they grabbed the watchtower. Arthas will already recapture that. And we have a nice little distribution on the lane. So no experience missed so far. I think playing with Pain is a little bit ahead in the XP. Maybe because early on we did have a noob missing there for a sec, maybe.
Yeah. Both teams are just going for the easy camps right now. Pretty standard against those lanes because they are not likely to get ganked, and both the teams playing quite defensively on lane.
Yeah, Arthas is taking a lot of damage at going for this easy camp. Now he's being supported by Abathur. Maybe a little bit late, but he can go for the healing well if he really wants to, or before any big engagement he should at least. Unless Rhaegar gets in there to give him a heal beforehand.
Yeah, maybe Rhaegar gets
But he's too close to the gate, and of course he has the minions up front, so he should be fine. He should be fine. At least not overextend or anything.
Now we have the siege camp already pushing bottom.
So that's an amazing timing here. Luvi going to support that siege camp, and now everyone for Playing with Pain can just move into position to get a good, nice grab on that tribute.
Yeah, and Siege is there as well, so he might be able to grab Rhaegar. Really nice, but no follow-up over there.
Yeah, Arthas is moving in. Nice stun there on Tychus. Can he get another hold? Nope. There comes the stun by Uther. And looks like Arthas has to move back for now. Everyone is moving back. Oh, Hook's missing Arthas just by a sack there. Yeah. And looks like they have to retreat for now.
Yeah, Pain is really low. He shouldn't engage too much now.
And they always try to grab the tribute. I feel like it's not really safe yet. There's the stun on Arthas, and he's taking a lot of damage and is taken out. Felset needs to watch out now with everyone moving in. Tychus, Reyna, and Zeratul tries to grab the tribute, but there's the interrupt. But it looks like they will get the first tribute here.
Yeah. Meanwhile, we had Abathur being on bot lane, pushing hard, and I think that's the exact right choice here for him.
Oh. Yeah, they're already out of ammo, so he's going to take out this gate. Everyone's moving down, but it's going to be a little bit too late. I think at least the gate should fall here. But Abathur needs to watch out. He's in a lot of trouble if he gets spotted here.
Yeah, hard camp now being taken by PPP, quite standard there. They don't have that much to do, but meanwhile the bottom lane is uncontested here from PPP, so as you just said, they'll probably lose the gate.
Yeah, One of the towers had a little bit of ammo again, but I think now that the hard mobs are moving in, the hard camp is moving in top, they have the time to deal with this on bottom. Oh, Reyna is moving away again, so maybe they do have the time to just take out this gate. And they're pushing it really hard here with Falstad. But the next tribute is incoming. This time around, Team Prism is in position. Oh, Rhaegar trying to get the move on here on Azeroth.
Brilliant.
Nice pull on Arthas. Can they get him? Oh, he might get away though. He has Abathur on his back.
Yeah, and a really nice time now for the hard camp to be pushing for PPP. So they lay even more pressure down.
Good hook again. But Anoop gets away with the deep dive. But now they're really, really split up. Anoop can't really engage without endangering himself too much. So he needs to get up there. And I think they're not going to take this tribute as well. Otherwise, they'll lose the team fight.
Yeah, they should just retreat now, maybe.
But they're doing a good job trying to stop the capturing of the tribute. And now, now playing with Pain is also a little bit split up here. And yeah, they're managing this really well. But it looks like Uther can get the final look there. Maybe Falstad is moving in, and they're seeing the rub just in time. Can he get away though? Ooh, nice stun, getting Zeratul pretty low. But wow. Not quite killing him.
Really nice kill here on Arthas. Hysterica being so low on the Tychus, but still managing to get away.
Ooh, Falstad is moving in from the bottom, but he gets... Oh no, he's trapped. He's trapped. And Zeratul takes him out. And now, 5v3, I think they can finally take that tribute. And maybe even lure up the hard camp here, but that's a little bit dangerous. Maybe not going for that.
But as we just saw, PvP was down in experience a little bit, and they are now as well, just because of Abathur stayed on the bottom lane. It's incredible how much he can help out over there.
Yeah, and I think in the meantime, he's also switched to some of these heroes. He was on Noob and Arthas every once in a while. Oh, nice stun here on Uther, but without the follow-up, of course, he's no real danger. We already have parts of the wall missing here on the top lane.
Yeah, and Prism is gonna get level 10 soon now, even grabbing the easy camp now. And maybe Rhaegar is gonna go for the hard camp together with Arthas. Might be a good option for them, but then they lose the opportunity to fight a 10 versus 9 fight.
Oh, wow. That was pretty close here for Abathur. He was safe behind those minions, but I mean, with Raynor, he could have easily pushed him out of there. Now we have the easy camp defending here on the bot lane as well, so Abathur has an easy time to stop this. And, oh wow, Pain with Pain already going for the boss.
Yeah, and they got a perfect position here on the tribute. They won't have any problems whatsoever now to get the tribute, and that with the curse, together with the boss' incredible pushing power.
Yeah, that's just amazing. I mean, the boss is just going to take on the whole bottom lane by himself. They're gonna have no trouble getting the tribute, and the only right choice here for Prism is of course also going for the boss, just to give a little bit of an edge on their top lane to, I don't know, counter push a little bit here. That's really the only way to stop this, but looks like Pain with Pain is incoming here on the middle lane.
Yeah,
but they did get the boss.
Yeah, and it looks like the bottom fort is gonna fall if Prism doesn't defend.
And they're moving in. They're moving in from the right side, but it's 5v3. They're still missing someone here.
Yeah, and Nubarak wasn't there. And now Luvi joins the frame.
Well, they did push him back for now. Now Anoop is there, and they're just waiting, waiting for the initiate here. And there it comes. Nice initiate. Anoop is moving in, but he's getting a lot of damage dealt. There's the healing, and really good healing. But there comes the. There comes the CC from Uther, and Anoop is taken out. With Anoop, without Anoop, they definitely have to retreat.
Yeah. And meanwhile, the bottom fort fall, and the golem was just so good pushing, and now PvP is gonna defend the top golem, I think. Oh no, they don't even have to, but they're gonna go for it. And now they are already two levels ahead, so really nice engages here for
the
PvP.
Timing just worked out so well. As you pointed out, I mean, they grabbed the boss just in time for the third tribute, and then, I mean, they got a little bit lucky with the tribute spawning, of course, because it all just worked out so well. The boss, they got the boss and then just turned back for the tribute. Now they're going for the hard camp, just to add a little bit insult to that.
Yeah, they'll be able to push middle after this. So, yeah, quite solid gaming here from PPP. And, yeah, not really that much to do for Prism now. They obviously have to defend the upcoming camps.
Yeah, Noob just trying to take the top lane by himself. We have Abatha up there as well. He's a little bit exposed, and Noob is exposed as well. And there comes the initiate and the stun. Noob just goes down so quickly. And now they're just going to make the follow-up happen here on the top lane, taking out this fort with no real repercussions. I mean, looks like Team Prism might be trying to save it. No, they're retreating. They know it's gone. They don't have the power without a Noob to go in there.
Yeah.
I mean, they're really, really dependent on that line stun by a Noob.
And we see again Abatha being on the bottom lane. I think he even used promote. Wow. Yeah. He gone for promote on level 4. Interesting talent, but really nice at pushing.
Yeah, they... Well, I think they have a lot of minions now to probably take on this fort. But at the same time, wow, massive fight up here. There's the heroic visor tool and catching everyone. Arthas is the first one to fall. Anoop also getting a lot of damage, but there's comes the ancestral healing. Anoop copies moving in. He's taken out. And now they're staying back. They definitely have to stay back. There's another line stun, but not getting anyone there. And with the easy camp, they're going to have an easy time to also push up, push down this top lane.
Yeah, even Udin popped now. So best fort will definitely fall. Really nice engage here by Anubarak, but not enough follow-up, obviously. Oh, nice hook here. Really
amazing hook. And he gets him, moves him back, and Falset is taken out. And yeah, now they don't have any power to stop this. But looks like they're gonna retreat, grab the tribute instead. So I think that Team Prism got a little bit lucky here, that they finally have the time to grab their easy camp and also not get totally death pushed on the top lane.
Yeah. Meanwhile, we had Abatha killing the bottom fort, so quite nice, quite nicely done.
Yeah, and he knows that he's really exposed up there, so he just teleported back towards the Nexus. And we have the hard camp pushing in the middle now.
Yeah, so much map control now by PPP. They can just creep wherever they want.
Yeah, they're gonna go for their own boss now. And then they already have one tribute, so probably just grab the boss now, put on a little bit of pressure, and then once they do grab these other tributes, since they know, okay, Prism has to deal with the boss first, they probably have the upper hand in grabbing the tribute, and then just go for the third tribute and do the final push with the third tribute.
It even looked like PvP wants to get an ambush now on Prism when they try to gank them here at the boss.
But the boss is already grabbed, and whoa, nice job! But Uther goes down in that fight, getting off another heroic, but not quite catching the other heroes here. Noob falls. Falset tries to engage Rainer there, but he's all by himself. Tychus moves in, and he pushes him back. And Noob is caught in between everyone here.
Yeah, but it's only the
getaway.
It's not the real one. Oh no, it was the real one. Oh, was it? No, the real one died before. So
yeah, he went down beforehand. But now everyone is on retreat. Arthas might actually get away with ancestral healing. Oh no, he gets stunned just as he tries to mount up. And now Zeratul can probably take him out. Oh, quite a little bit missing the hook there. He got away. Amazing heal here by Thunder. And now they do have the time to finally take that boss. So the idea here by Team Prism was actually really, really good. Grabbing them while they're still occupied with the boss.
Yeah, but PPP already thought they will go for this. And they didn't exercise it completely right, I think, but at least they didn't stand like totally out of position when they got ganked there.
Since we have a lot of people asking in chat why are they even taking Abathur, I do have to give props to Abathur. I think he's doing a really good job pushing these top and bottom lanes. And without him, I think they would have lost the experience game here already. But with him bringing all these forts, I think they're still doing good.
Yeah, surprising.
They're still in the game. They just grabbed the boss, so they're going to push hard on top or just let the boss push, then probably split push somewhere else, maybe stop the boss beforehand, otherwise they might lose this bottom fort here in their main base.
Yeah, so as you can see, it's 10 against 1 kills and still only half a level at the moment. So, yeah.
The next tribute spawning on the blue team's side, so playing with pain. If they get there in time, and they should be there a little bit early, but oh no, we have a nuke moving in. Maybe if he can get in a good position to set up the line stun, and that would be a good position right there. We already have Zeratul moving in, but he knows what's up, and there comes the stun. Arthas moves in on the left side. They kind of split up a little bit here, and another deep dive by the copy. And another good stun, taking out Stitches and Rainer at the same time. And the follow-up stun, wow! Team Prism is on fire, but can they dish out the damage? Everyone is really clumped up. Arthas falls, and there's the Void Prism on the right side, taking out half of Team Prism. That's really unfortunate. With that Gush initiate, I thought they could finish him off, but didn't work out in the end. And now they're on the retreat. Have to save these remaining heroes at least. Another heal here by Rega. I think they should be getting away, but that was quite unfortunate. Now we have the third tribute for playing with pain.
Yeah, the fight was really interesting, but at the exact right second, there was the Divine Storm by Luby. Uther just pulled it off in the very right second because he just cancelled the heroic of Falstead. So he wasn't able to dish out the damage.
Yeah, and the Void Prism helped out immensely as well. And now they're just going for the middle fort. We still have 2 heroes on cooldown. Now Arthas is back. And I think this kind of saved them now. Because now I feel like they're not going to go for the Nexus straight away. They're going to take out the top fort first and then play it safe. Just come back with the boss next time and just retreat for now. Because if Arthas and Anoop would have been gone for a little bit longer, I think they're just going to push the Nexus. They would have just pushed the Nexus and won the game right then and there.
Yeah, might be a really good engage now for... Ah, no. They don't have the Abathur heroic up, so
yeah, then
they
won't
engage.
Really, they're not really moving in in a synchronized fashion here.
Yeah, Abathur pushing bottom lane once more with the easy camp, but not really achieving a lot there.
Yeah, the timing on the hard camp was a little bit bad here for playing with pain, but they do have the time to grab their own boss if it does come up.
Yeah, the thing why they got their hard camp is just they don't have to defend the enemy's hard camp now, basically.
Yeah, if they wouldn't have gotten it, you're right. Prism would have just grabbed it, and they would have run into a little bit of trouble. That was just not for pushing, but rather to not have the enemy get it.
And we have level 20 now for PvP, so they're gonna have an easy time pushing now. Taking the last
Resurgence on Stitches, and Bolt of the Storm on Rainer and Zeratul. Big red button for Tychus, and the Vine Hurricane for Uther. And whoa, they're just going for the bottom lane in the main camp now. Anoop moves in, nice stun, getting the stun there on Stitches, but he just moves in with the Devourer and grabs him. Now everything's just so clumped up. Luffy might go down, but Anoop Rock falls first. Stitches is killed in that engagement up there, and Zeratul also killed. If they get another hero here, they might make the turnaround happen.
Yeah, but it looks like... the Sarig is gonna get away. Oh no, he was incredible.
Not
though.
Quite. Thunder might run into a little bit of trouble with that Uther still remaining. And Rainer is on the run. Can they get a kill on Rainer? Yep, there's the stun. And Detrom comes the body block. Arthas doing a really good job.
A really nice fight here.
Yeah.
From Prism.
Amazing turnaround. Now they're also level 20. And we have Abathur pushing top now as well. Maybe they can take out bottom and kind of do the split push with Abathur on top. Yeah, the top four is for sure gonna fall. Tychus can't do anything about it. It's gonna fall. Stitches, I mean.
Yeah, and Prism might even be able... no. Tribute is spawning, so they won't go for the boss. They would have had the time, maybe, if they had Abathur with them to dish out some damage.
Yeah, I think they should be going for the tributes, but I mean, I'm kind of surprised. I mean, they're with this Abathur, they were able to, hold their ground against Playing with Pain, even though they didn't grab a single tribute so far. And looks like they will get this middle fort as well. Maybe not.
That's quite dangerous.
Pain is moving in. Uther is there. Not quite ready with this heroic. Nice grab. And they're gonna get a noob. There's no way around it. He's just caught in the middle. Whoa!
Nice almost save. Managing.
Wow! With the double disengage. Wow. Really well done. That was amazing by Sarkonic.
Yeah. Ooh, and barely missing the hook over there. Really nicely done. And now we have both teams probably going for their bosses, as it looks like. At the moment, Prism is even ahead in levels. Of course, they are down in forts, but levels matter a little bit still.
Just healing up first, and now they're going for their boss. Yeah, you're right. I'm probably just going to grab the hard camp efforts. Oh, and that's an amazing, amazing timing here on the tribute, and it's so close to the boss, so I think just sniping the boss, going for the tribute right away. But, looks like they might be in trouble here, with Playing with Pain moving in towards the easy camp, and then just, ignoring the tribute and going for the Nexus straight away.
Yeah, they're going for the back door, but Prism immediately going back, everybody, except for Rhaegar, obviously. Don't think PvP has the power now to kill them, actually. But maybe with the Grave Golem they have a chance. Already Abathur heroic up. They might just go in with the Odin.
But yeah, I think they're waiting for some big mistake on the boss. And there comes the Divine Storm. But they get away. And whoa, nice Void Prism getting three heroes.
Oh, and the Shock and Awe was pulled off too early. Now a lot of trouble. For a new rock, but nice.
Yeah, amazing heal here on the copy, and they're doing a really good job just defending everything. And Arthas is the first one to fall, the copy will fall as well. And now it's just 4 against 5. They might run into a little bit of trouble. Oh, the boss just takes it out by himself.
Yeah, really nice strategic decision here from PvP, trying to fight as long as possible so the Grave Golem can simply. Kill the enemy core.
Yeah, he does a decent amount of damage.
Yeah.
And if your team is completely occupied with dealing with the enemy team, getting that good timing, just, I mean, you see how it works. All right. I was really surprised that Prism did such a good job to hold their ground here against Playing with Pain. I mean, this is third place against last place in the standings right now. And they did an amazing job, I gotta say. And even with that Abathur, I mean, he was pretty good. Just pushing down top and bottom lane, getting that experience that they missed in the team fights. And he really made up. And I think this is how you should play Abathur if you do gonna choose him.
Yeah, and we talked about it beforehand as well. Always, the comebacks are happening, just as we saw. In the end, it wasn't enough, but they are happening. In the end game, it's so easy to just come back with one team fight, and if the enemy team doesn't have enough forts, they are just going to lose as well, because of the downtimes are so long.